Ready? Whoa. Yikes. Reload, hurry up.
Our victory is their defeat.
Wow, I thought it was dead. It kept going. It likes to eat toss ball cards. Jesus, they eat a lot, these things. It was only two? She felt like we fought like three or four of them. Oh.
Here we go!
Sliding into first. Jeez, these things will eat anything. Gyroscope management terminal. Let's just take a look around before we go over there. It's that little thing? That's the terminal? Or does it open the way for the terminal? Don't do that growling stuff. I don't like that. I'll kill you. Don't push me, man. Don't push me. What's in here? Did we just come from here? Oh, there's two doors, right. We have two doors, guys, two doors. I'm just padding around. Sounds like I'm wearing my footy pajamas. Pat, 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 pat. Well, there's actually absolutely nothing else in here to fool with, huh? No little hidden loot or anything? Alright. Why does this look like a trap or something? That comes down. Execute the gyroscopic axial realignment procedure. Why do we have to take 1,000 elevators just to do that? Meet Mabel at the gyroscope management terminal. She has a plan to deal with the canids, allegedly. I think I've already dealt with the canids. Execute the gyroscopic axial realignment procedure. It's as simple as it sounds. That's so. Oh. Yep. Mabel. I have the key. I'm pushing the button myself. First, let's see what's in here. I got a model spaceship. Sealed. Huh. Overheat maintenance pipes. Why would I want to do that? Let's talk to her. I want to do it myself, though. I'm gonna put this away.
By the law, those canids are done for. We did it, friend.
We did not do anything. You watched while I did the work.
Yes. Well, that's a supervisor's job. Anyway, I was thinking, you should do the honors. Realign Phaeton.
I was going to.
Since you've been such great help in all of this.
Lady, Rizzo should be making me captain at this point. I know I wouldn't get any response on that because it's a leave conversation thing. Oh, notice that option, that grayed out option, is not even here yet. I guess that's if I want to act against her. I'd probably be destroying the entire complex, though. Execute gyroscopic axial realignment procedure. Boop. Axial realignment complete. Please interface with Phaeton to confirm attitude adjustment. Yeah, I hope he changes his attitude completely. Oh, that opens. That's cool. I did it.
Nicely done. Someone should really give you a promotion.
I don't work for that company. I'm an independent contractor. Where the hell am I now? Huh. Goodies. Cool. Oh, it's the fast track back. Seems like a rocky elevator to me. It makes me nervous. It's supposed to shake this much? I mean, look at the indicator, how it moves. Oh, the sealed, the barred door. I come out the side here, in the museum area. Cool. Yeah, I was like kind of expecting with that elevator like a Amnesia the Dark Descent thing when Daniel falls in the elevator. Yeah, no one important. I'm the real engineer here.
Greeting protocols suspended. Checking for gyroscopic alignment.
Don't worry about the greeting.
Gyroscopic alignment confirmed. Rizzo's thanks you for your assistance.
You're welcome.
All systems are functional.
Yeah, quieter there. Done. You save the Eridanos atmospheric complex from eventual catastrophe. Oh, we still need to find the guy's part. A wrecked sentry automechanical. I killed so many. I guess it's gotta be a special one. Does it give me an idea? That's probably outside. Was there any other quest here? No. There were those two quests. Scrap metal is down there. homing in on it. I never would have found it without that. Scrap metal from the wreckage of a century automechanical. Indeed. Well, let's go back to this guy then. Wait. How do I get up from here? Yeah, there we go. You have to test the wind before you make a move like that. The wind's moving the wrong way, it's not gonna work. Well, we found it. He's more on the side here, though. Is that me breathing? Hi.
You're back! Any luck finding what we need for the Pteroray grounder?
Yep, here's what I found.
Excellent! I should finally be able to get this thing working!
I hope so.
Here, take this! It's the least I can do for all your help against those leathery abominations.
Huh.
Oh, wait. There's one more thing. You don't happen to have a pinwheel, do you?
I do like that. Leathery abominations. What do you need a pinwheel for?
It'll help generate electricity as we move through the atmosphere. Plus, all Rizzo's products are supposed to have an element of whimsy.
An element of whimsy? Okay, I can look for one.
Great. I'll give you a nice bonus if you bring one back to me.
A bonus?
You're back. Any luck finding what we need for the Pteroray grounder?
Pinwheel. Reminder of that Nickelodeon show called Pinwheel, which was like a 6-hour long show or something. Pinwheel! That's how they would say it. It's down below and it's down there. Ow. Insult to injury. Oh, this? I didn't even see that. And I was here. Oh, I'm like, who are they? I keep doing that. Whenever they're not near me, they're just hanging around, like, acting normal. I think they're NPCs. Ah, see, the wind. The wind was not with me there. That's exactly what I was telling you guys. Come on, wind. Blow in my direction. There you go. What's that description of the pinwheel? It spins and flashes in the breeze. Hooray. Is he gonna send me back for one more thing after this? He's gonna... Bonus. Back again.
You're back! Any luck finding what we need for the Pteroray grounder?
I found the pinwheel. Is that everything? I really hope so.
It sure is! I'll finally be able to give those winged monstrosities what for! Here's your pay for helping me put the finishing touches on this thing!
I sure would hate to see something happen to your lovely machine there.
Me too! And if a few other bits keeps it safe, they're yours! Thanks again for your help, Inspector.
Thanks for playing ball.
Thanks for your help with the Pteroray grounder.
No problem. I'll intimidate you again should the need arise. Have no fear. Loading screen tip could be here. You see that? Your loading script Your loading screen tip could be here. Even our loading screens have ads. Alright, so that's finished. You brought Thelbert everything he needs to complete his Pteroray trap. Hooray. Cedric. Yeah, I could talk to Ludovico. Then again, I know where the cantina is. We can just fast travel there. Black hole Bertie. Here we come. Underneath the dry goods and sundry. Clot form serum. Yummy. So, if it isn't the one and only Bertie Holcomb, that's a silly hat.
What do you want?
You're Black Hole Bertie, right?
Not so loud!
I whispered it.
You know it was me.
Do you have any idea how many tossball posters your face is on?
That's what the disguise is for.
What disguise?
I'm in no mood to sign autographs, and I hate disappointing fans. So I'm lying low. You know, incompleto.
That's, incognito.
Oh, yeah, I guess it's kinda neato. Oh, what's it matter? Helen's gone. She's gone and nothing I do will bring her back.
Well, that's true.
I've been trying to find who did this. That's what she would do. Track down the killer and bring them to justice. Mm. But I'm stumped. And not very clever. Being bright was always Helen's thing.
There are many types of intelligence, Mr. Holcomb. For example, your, expertise on the field. Your hack attack is nothing short of brilliant.
I don't care how smart he is. What I care about is the man's alibi.
Oh, so you're the inspector. Hope you have more luck figuring things out than me. Hmm. You probably want to ask me some questions, huh? I'm sure you're asking everybody questions, so you can find Helen's killer.
Huh?
So, how do I help?
Catches on real quick, doesn't he? What were you doing the night Helen died?
I was getting blotto with the rest of the Rangers.
What? He's getting drunk.
You know, soaked, muddled, preserved.
Inebriated?
He's saying he was drunk, Captain.
I know.
The team noticed I was in a bad way when I got back to the hotel. When I told them Helen and I were Splitsville, they wanted to cheer me up. We were up the pole afore evening. The hotel staff said we was bothering the other guests on account of all the crying and yelling and practice body tackling. Zeke said we should move elsewhere. Get some air.
Where'd you go?
We ended up at the Wilderness Exploitation Reserve. I think somebody wanted to pet a woolly cow. There was this one cow off away from the others. Zeke figured it'd be a laugh to get her drunk. One thing led to another, and I think we might have maybe, you know, stolen her.
What'd you steal a cow for?
I don't know. We were drunk. And we made bad choices. She was all alone. I know how that feels now. It's so hard to be all by your lonesome. My memory's a little muddled after that. I guess me and the team got split up, because I know I was on my own at the pilot house for a time.
Hmm. Could anyone from the pilot house back that up?
I reckon not. See, I went to the weather station. I was looking for where Helen stashed her data pad for safekeeping, right?
Oh, I need that.
She'd asked me to get it, mind. I wasn't stealing. I'm no thief.
And did you find it? Although this is a good thing to say as well.
Sure did. Only there was a guard out there who found me. She started yelling about how I was trespassing and in serious trouble. Thing is, it was real dark out there. So dark, she couldn't tell who I was.
You sure this guard couldn't ID you?
Real sure. It was dark as night gets. Plus, I've got small veins.
Small veins.
Anyway, I didn't much feel like trying to explain why I was out there, or why I was drunk, and holding someone else's data pad, and also maybe crying a little, so I booked it.
Where's the data pad?
Ran like the Rangers were down by three, and I just bronzed the toss ball in the Friday zone.
Did anyone else see you that night? Think hard now. Anyone? Anywhere else?
Yeah, I mean, no. Nope. No one else.
He started to say, yeah. I would have to be dead to not realize that's a lie.
Can we pretend I didn't mention that?
No.
I don't want to tell you. I'll get in trouble.
Yeah, I try to be nice. Time to lean on this guy, Vicar.
Trouble. An interesting concept. Depends on who's making the rules, doesn't it? One man's hero is another man's villain and all that? Don't make us be the villains here, Bertie.
But
wait. What?
I wanted you to wrap him up.
Is he threatening me? Am I being threatened?
You heard the man.
Look, I talked to Oryk, okay? Oryk West. Hangs out around the spaceport. He's the one who taught me the breathing exercises I use to calm down.
Your bookie? Murderous confidant? Secret paramour with whom you're having a torrid affair?
Confidant is like confidence. What's torrid mean?
Who's Oryk, Bertie?
Don't get the wrong idea, okay? Oryk's not a bad guy. He's just got an unusual job. So
what?
Now you have the whole story.
No.
After I talked to Oryk, I went back to the hotel.
I need to know who he is.
Woke up the next morning with Helen's data pad in my hand and the hangover to end all hangovers. Don't know if I'll ever drink again.
Any advice for next time, Ellie?
A shot of Spectrum mixed in a Gigantor energy drink first thing in the morning. Works like a charm.
I think that probably counts as drinking, but thanks, ma'am. Anyway,
yes.
You ought to take Helen's datapad. Maybe you'll have better luck understanding her notes. Either she was writing in code, or I'm dumber than a bag of hammers.
The latter.
I tried for hours to crack her notes, but it's like I said. Being bright was Helen's thing.
It's all relative, you know. There's still a gap in your timeline, though, Bertie. I'm not sure a blackout will cut it.
I know that. But you gotta believe me. I would never hurt Helen, no matter how drunk I was. You could preserve me in Spectrum Brown, and I wouldn't even look at her funny. I want to help you find her killer, Inspector. I knew Helen better than anybody. And it could be handy to have a guy like me around, in case anybody gives you trouble.
I can't let a suspect be part of the investigation. It doesn't really work that way.
I get it. I'll head back to the Grand Colonial, then. Unless you need me for anything else?
I do have a few more questions.
What do you want to know?
About Oryk West. You never did tell me who the hell he is.
Yeah?
What's his deal?
Oryk's a businessman. He sells stuff you can't get elsewhere. You know, alternative stuff.
Mm.
We're talking sort of science, crockery, whole supplements.
Is that what he means? Why would someone buy whole supplements?
Maybe putting effort accelerators in your body isn't always the right call, you know? Maybe there are other options. Maybe I don't take all the accelerators Rizzo's pushes on me.
Maybe I should just forget that last one so you don't get in trouble with Rizzo's.
Oh, yeah. I'd appreciate that. Yeah?
Where can I find... Oryk? Is that his name?
Oryk hangs around the spaceport most days. Since he's not here at the bar, he's most likely over by the biobunks at the shipping yard.
Biobunks, okay, I know where that is. Why'd you have the mascot pull that little stunt over the recording in Helen's room?
I remember sending her the recording, but... Law, I was halfway to preserved by then. I don't know what was on it. When I realized what I'd done, I panicked. If I'd said something dumb, folks might think I was involved in her death. I was scared of looking suspicious.
Concealing evidence is a crime.
Like I said, I panicked.
About Helen.
What about her?
Why did you break up?
I wish I knew. Must have been something I did. At the picnic, Helen just kept saying she didn't want to drag me into her world. Maybe one of the higher-ups in motion pictures was giving her trouble over us? I don't know. I tried to understand, but I don't.
Well, she found out something she was looking into, and she didn't want him to get involved. Either for his own safety or because she's worried that he's so dull he might mess it up. What was your relationship with her like?
Look, you and me, we both know I'm a big, dumb tossball star, right? That's what I'm good at. Rizzo's knows it. The fans know it. Helen, she saw me as more than that. She saw someone who had more to offer than big muscles and a signature black hole stomp. Being with Helen was magic. She was magic. There ain't good enough words for something as special as what we had together.
Hmm. What? Why'd you break up again?
I wish I knew. Must have been one of the higher-ups in motion pictures was
any enemies?
Trouble up. Rival actresses, maybe? I don't know too much about the motion picture industry. Except for Helen's pictures, obviously. Those I probably know by heart. Seen them about 100 times each.
That's all, huh?
What do you want to know?
What's it like being a famous tossball player?
Tossball was, is, and always will be the greatest game in the universe. And I would give it up in a heartbeat to have Helen back.
You haven't seen the entire universe. Alright, so we gotta go meet... Oryk, who's like right there. He's... Oh, I talked to him before. He's the one who looks like Steve Harrington.
What can I do you for?
Just a little more messed up. I'd like to ask you some questions about Bertie Holcomb.
Wait, you ain't a sheriff, right? You gotta tell me if you're a sheriff.
What makes you think I'm a sheriff?
Because you talk like one. I'd like to ask you some questions. No one says that outside of the serials.
Answer the damn questions already.
All right, fine. Yeah, I know Bertie. So what?
How do you know Bertie?
He may or may not buy alternatives from me from time to time. A little diluted mantis or essence here, a little vitamin B negative there.
Do you look more from Steve Harrington from the other side? What for?
He's stressed out of his mind, the poor guy. Everyone knows his name. Can't turn around without having to sign an autograph. Then you throw in playing tossball for a living. Violence like that, it does things to a body. It does things to the head.
What do you mean tossball does things to the head?
Come on. Bertie's a damn good hacker. But taking that many blows to the noggin would scramble anyone's upstairs business. I know it's knocked a few of his memories loose.
That's not all.
I worry about him, that's all. He's a good kid. Got a good heart.
Was Bertie with you the night Halcyon Helen was killed?
Yeah. Damn shame about that. Bertie thought the world of Helen, you know. He showed up drunk at my place wanting to talk about the breakup. Helen dumped him, he said. Boy, was he in a bad way. I'd never seen him like that before. We talked for a while, and when he felt better, I sent him back to the hotel. Told him to drink more water and get some sleep.
I don't think he drank any water. I heard you taught Bertie some breathing techniques?
Yeah, that was me. Bertie's got a temper, but he's not a bad kid, you know? He's trying to work on it.
By asking that, I confirm that... What do you call it? The alibi. I confirm the alibi. Prince of Tossball. You've learned that Black Hole Bertie was at the Wilderness Exploitation Reserve and then the Pilot House for some amount of time on the night of the murder, but there's a period where Bertie is unable to account for his whereabouts. You should report to Administrator Ludovico at the Penthouse Terminal and decide what to tell him regarding Bertie. Bertie admitted to sending the Rizzo's Rangers mascot to ransack Helen's room in search of a recording. He was afraid of being tied to Helen's murder. Okay. Yeah, I don't think it was Black Hole Bertie. If I had to guess, and please don't confirm or deny, guys, although maybe by the time you watch this, I will have been done, but can't guarantee that. I don't know how much longer we have to go. But what I think is that someone higher up, maybe Ludovico himself, and is trying to implicate... What's the guy's name? He's trying to implicate Spencer Woolrich in the murder. I don't think it's actually Spencer Woolrich. That's too simple. But anyway, we'll find out. Eventually. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.